JIAN-KEN from MakeTech here. This video covers a CNC machine build. We're using a kit from Avid CNC as the base machine. Here I'm bringing in all the boxes from the pallet it arrived on. Let's take a look at the components I've procured. This VFD is the E550 from Sunfar. It is single phase 3.7 kilowatts up to 1 kHz. These are ClearPath servos from Technics. As you can see, they're packaged really nicely. These are NEMA 34 with half inch shaft. Technics produces very high quality products and their customer service has been outstanding. Here are the power and data cables for the servos and the 75 volt power supply. They suggested using dielectric grease on these connectors. This is an ATC spindle from JIAN-KEN. Its specs are 2.5 kilowatts, 30,000 RPM, pneumatic tool changer ISO 20 collets, and it's water cooled. JIAN-KEN had great communication, great packaging, and fast delivery. Pneumatic valve from eBay, Tunes aquarium pump for spindle coolant, auto parts catch can, large heatsink, Ethernet smooth stepper, breakout board from Steppers Online, analog pressure sensor, pneumatic manifold, and air and coolant hose. This is the shaft coupler from Avid CNC. Through miscommunication, they sent the wrong size, but luckily I could easily drill it out to the correct size. Okay, now back to the Avid CNC kit. As you can see, they've packaged everything really well, and it was all nicely tied down to the shipping pallet. When I was putting this together, I had the instruction manual up on one screen and the video from Avid CNC on the other. This made it relatively easy to follow along and build the kit. I'm just starting with the two Y axes and joining them to the four cross members. They're 1.3 meters long and provide 935 millimeters of travel. Avid CNC have developed a nice fixture method for the extrusions, making it quite quick and easy to assemble the unit. The T-slot table can be installed at different heights. I've chosen the mid-height so the top of the table is almost flush with the Y-axis. These are the gantry riser plates. They're quite solid, 20mm thick. Here's the gantry main extrusion section. I've put the T-nuts in, then moved the machine onto its end and placed the extrusions between the gantry risers. Okay, so I've mounted the X-axis onto the gantry and then the Z axis onto that. I had to remove the red side covers to mount the X and Z axis. The way I've done it is different than in the instructions due to Avid CNC changing their design slightly. Now I'm mounting the servos, carefully measuring the position of the coupler so that it has maximum engagement without being squashed, starting with one of the Y axes. Now the X-axis servo. And the Z-axis servo. Finally the second Y-axis servo. Now the cable chain. I was quite impressed with the size of these cable chains. There's plenty of room for extra cables, pneumatic lines, and coolant hose. Next step is installing the T-slot table. I had to put the extrusions on, mark the hole locations, and insert the roll-in T-nuts. I adjusted their position and fastened it all down. I've skipped ahead a bit here. I've got the spindle installed and I'm measuring out the pneumatic hose. This is the current state of progress. Next, I'll be working on the electrical and then an enclosure for the machine.